A very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to continue with our chapter local governments, and under that chapter we will start 74th amendment. Under 73rd amendment, local self-government were established at three levels and in the rural areas, but under 74th amendment, this amendment is dealing with urban local bodies or Nagar Palikas. Now the question arises that what is an urban area? Aakhir urban area hunda hi ki hai. It's very easy if you want to identify a big city like Mumbai, Kolkata, Bangalore, Delhi. But there are certain small urban areas also. And according to the Census of India, it is defining urban area. Urban area ki ek definition ditti gayi hai that it should have a minimum population of 5,000. The second criteria is that at least 75% of the male members should be working in non-agricultural occupations. They should not be doing agriculture, because agriculture is the main occupation in the rural areas. And third, a density of population of at least 400 persons per square kilometer should be the density. And according to the census of 2011, 31% of India's population is living in urban areas. Now, 74th Amendment, it is a repetition of 73rd Amendment, but it applies to the urban areas, and all the provisions that were under 73rd Amendment that are same to same in 74th Amendment. These are: direct elections will be held, reservation for scheduled caste, tribes and women, backward classes, transfer of subjects that are mentioned in the 12th schedule of the Indian Constitution. There will be one state election commission will be established, whose function will be to organize the elections of local governments, and state finance commission who will monitor the financial part of these local governments. And these will apply to Nagar Palikas also. And one more question can come here from here, that the functions of local government, they are enlisted in the 12th schedule. In which schedule? 12th schedule. Now let us see the implementation of 73rd and 74th amendment. All states have passed legislation to implement the provisions of 73rd and 74th amendment. During 10 years, starting from 1994 to 2004, several states had two rounds of elections to their local bodies, and some states like Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, they have conducted three elections. If you see this image, it's a symbol of the expectations of the people about the local government. They are saying Amra Gamma Ami Raj, Mera hi gaon hai और यहाँ पर मेरा ही राज्य होना चाहिए, ना कि स्टेट या सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का. आज की तारीख में देखें तो हमारे पास वी हैव 600 जिला पंचायत, 6,000 ब्लॉक और इंटरमीडियरी पंचायत, 2,40,000 ग्राम पंचायत एंड 100 सिटी कॉरपोरेशंस, 1,400 टाउन म्युनिसिपैलिटीज हैव बीन सेट अप एंड अबाउट 2,000 नगर पंचायत हैव बीन मेड in urban India. 32 lakh members, they are elected to these local bodies after every 5 years, out of which 13 lakh are women section. They have created this 73rd amendment. It has created a uniformity in the structure of Panchayati Raj and Nagar Palika institution. Ek tarah di यूनिफॉर्मिटी लेके आया है ये अमेंडमेंट, दोनों ही अमेंडमेंट, 73rd से 74th अमेंडमेंट. एंड देयर इज अ रिजर्वेशन फॉर वुमेन सेक्शन एट द पंचायत्स एंड नगर पालिकास. वी हैव अ सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर ऑफ वुमेन इन लोकल बॉडीज. इन दिस रिजर्वेशन इज ऑल्सो एप्लीकेबल टू द पोजिशंस ऑफ सरपंच एंड अध्यक्षास. We have 200 women adhyakshas in Zilla Panchayats, 2,000 women who are the presidents of block or taluka panchayats, and more than 80,000 women sarpanch in the Gram Panchayat. It means there is a reasonable rise in the total of the women section. And there are in the urban areas, Nagar Balikas, we have women mayors in corporation, 30 women mayors in corporation, 500 adhyakshas, city ki municipal, town municipality hundi hai, ode head no president, osi adhyaksha kehne ha, that are 500 in number, and 650 Nagar panchayats have been headed over by women section. But there are women have gained more and more power and confidence by asserting control over resources, but there are certain drawbacks also. Women were unable to assert presence or were mere proxies for the male members of the family who sponsored their election. But these kinds of examples, they are becoming fewer nowadays. आप देखेंगे इस पिक्चर में, let us see this photograph. The local सरकार is sitting out in the sun. Is there any feature that strikes you? Yes, it will be strike that it is a local government, local सरकार is sitting, but in the members, nobody is woman. Woman section is facing back to this photograph. वुमेन सेक्शन का कितने भी नाम ही नहीं है, बेशक वो उन्होंने प्रॉक्सीज के रूप में यूज किया जाता है बाय द मेल मेंबर्स। ये तुम समझाने लिए एक गल दसांगी, दैट लाइक सरपंच सीट की रिजर्वेशन वुमेन सेक्शन के लिए है, वुमेन का नाम लिख के भेजा जाएगा लेकिन सारे के सारे काम उसके हस्बैंड द्वारा किए जाएंगे। लेट अस सी द Reservation for scheduled castes and tribes, they have been made compulsory under the constitutional amendment. We have 16.2% scheduled caste population and 8.2% scheduled tribes population and about 6.6 lakh elected members in the urban and rural local bodies. They come from these two communities. Look, significantly, they have altered, they have changed the social profile of the local bodies. Local bodies, zyada to zyada, they have become more representatives of the social reality they operate within. Dominant class, jehdi dominant class, jivein pehle dekho ki sarpanch te kai zimindaran de hath de vich power hundi si, which controlled the village earlier, they do not wish to give up their power. Oh, apni power hun nahi chahunde ki जे सीट शड्यूल कास्ट नूं दित्ती जावे जां शड्यूल ट्राइब्स के मैंबर नूं दित्ती जावे ते ओह अपनी पावर नूं वापस करन दे हक दे विच बिल्कुल भी नहीं हन। नाउ देयर इज द स्ट्रगल फॉर पावर एंड मोर ओवर इन सम ऑफ द स्टेट्स एज प्रिस्क्राइब एज सजेस्टेड बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट हैज असाइंड एज मेनी एज 29 सब्जेक्ट्स टू द लोकल गवर्नमेंट। But many states have not transferred most of the subjects to the local bodies. So this is a very big drawback. We can criticize on this point also. The experience with the functioning of local government in the past decades has shown that local government in India enjoy limited autonomy to perform the functions assigned to them. They only perform कुछ लिमिटेड स्वतंत्रता, लिमिटेड इंडिपेंडेंसी लोकल गवर्नमेंट्स को है। लोकल बॉडीज उदों तक इफेक्टिवली काम नहीं कर सकदियां जदों तक सारे के सारे सब्जेक्ट्स उन्हां दे अंडर ना हो, क्योंकि कई स्टेट्स ने, एज ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, कई स्टेट्स ने सब्जेक्ट्स हैंडओवर नहीं किए हैं। कुछ लोग अजिहे भी हैं दैट दे क्रिटिसाइज द लोकल बॉडीज बिकॉज दिस हैज चेंज्ड, this has not changed the way in which the decisions are taken at the central and state level. The government at central level and state level, they take their own decisions, and the people at local level, they do not enjoy much powers of choosing welfare programs and allocation of the resources. Jede ki resources nu allocate karan di पावर है वो लोकल बॉडीज नो नहीं दी गई. दैट इज वाई इट इज वन ऑफ द मेजर ड्रॉबैक ऑफ लोकल गवर्नमेंट कि लोकल अथॉरिटीज नो लोकल लोगों नो अपने वेलफेयर प्रोग्राम्स नो चूज करन दा बिल्कुल भी हक नहीं दिता गया एंड द सब्जेक्ट्स आर सिलेक्टेड बाय द स्टेट एंड द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. मोरओवर लोकल बॉडीज हैव वेरी लिटिल फंड्स ऑफ देयर ओन. They have to depend on the state and central government for the financial support, and this has already eroded their capacity to operate effectively. क्योंकि उन्होंने finance के विच जिस source तो वो finance ले रहे ने capital ले रहे ने उन्होंने उन्होंने हक की गल करनी पैंदी है. There is an example given here. That rural local body they raise the total revenues by 0.24 and they account for total 4% of the total expenditure made by the government. It means that they earn much less but they spend much more, and this much more is provided to them by the state and the central government. So whatever is given to them they blindly have it, they enjoy that. And this also makes them totally dependent on state and central government who give them grants. Grants mainly state and central government के द्वारा आती हैं. ते पूरी दे पूरी local governments की पूरी dependency है. This is all with today's topic. I'm going to end the session now. If you have any doubt regarding this, better you can ask me. Thank you. Have a nice day at your houses.